What's going on, YouTube? It's Ninja Wire here, coming at you with another video today, and I'm presenting to you Star Wars Battlefront. Now, they released the beta on, I believe, Friday, and it's running until tomorrow, Tuesday, and it's only, five days long, unfortunately. I thought they were going to be running it a bit longer, which really sucks because this is a really super fun game. I'm really enjoying it, and I'll get into some of the aspects of stuff. So, with that said, I downloaded it on PC through Origin, and it looked like it downloaded the entire game, so it was like 10.5 gigs, so it took about 6 hours for me to download. Unfortunately, I live in rural Canada, and my internet's not super fast, so, took a little bit to download, but well worth it. Absolutely wonderful, wonderful game. I am just so fucking happy to be playing it. I'm so happy it came out in beta. I wasn't even expecting this, to be completely honest. I really haven't been taking the time to really research this game because I'm not as excited for it as Fallout 4. So I've been really researching into Fallout 4 and, you know, what the development of that's concerned and everything else. So Battlefront kind of sprung up and surprised me, which I'm enjoying. I'm really happy I did. So, downloaded it yesterday, got it finished, open it up, and I'm sitting there like, oh my god, this just looks absolutely beautiful, and it is. It is a gorgeous game. EA has done such a great job at making it look good. I think the updated graphics to Battlefront and everything else is just absolutely wonderful, and with a name like Battlefront, you've got to really own up to what the last two games were. Now, I don't think it's going to be as good as, say, the first Battlefront, and I don't know, I really am not a big fan of the second one. The space battles I was a huge fan of, but the rest of the gameplay really didn't cut it for me. I really didn't enjoy it as much as the very first one. Because the first one was really neat because it was just, you were just put in the shoes of an Imperial soldier, a CIS soldier, or, you know, like a fucking Wookiee. There were so many different options, and I love that, and I thought that was a really neat idea, and instead of adding the heroes in, which they have in both Battlefront 2 and the 2015 variant of Battlefront. So, I'm going to start out with a couple things that I kind of dislike with it, and then I'm going to go completely into the pros, because the pros outweigh the cons, like, completely. I think some of the level design, they're very big, they're very well done, but I think they're lacking a few of the key features of, say, you know, like a Star Wars universe, how I feel it would be. Now, I'm going back to my memories of the very first Battlefront with Hoth and the Rebel base and how big it was. It seemed like an actual real base, you know, like that was your feel from it. The gigantic hangar bay doors that you would run out of and that you would actually take off in your air speeders and, you know, or your snow speeders, as most people know them, and go out and be able to do all these things. And I thought that was a really neat kind of composition to it. So you're jumping into these vehicles that are there for you, and you're flying away, and you're fucking shit up and taking down AT-ATs with your tow, I guess your winch. And, you know, that was just such an awesome experience. It brought you back to the movie and how Luke did it in his snowspeeder and everything else. And it was an absolutely wonderful experience. And then this, they kind of took that away a little bit, I feel. The base just doesn't seem as big. It seems pretty small and compact. Like, this is just kind of part of it. And I don't know if they're going to expand more on the Hoth map itself. This might just be the game mode and how restricted it is as far as the game mode's concerned. So it's not infantry involved in a base and it's just kind of part of the base. I'm not really sure, but from what I'm getting from it, this is Hoth. And Hoth is supposed to be a rebel base, like a big rebel base. That was the whole point of Hoth, right? That was the whole point of being there, was this gigantic rebel base that could fuck shit up. And it just doesn't feel like that for me. Second one, you're losing that, like, that nice nostalgic feel of actually hopping into a vehicle. They have these pop-ups now, or these power-ups, I should say, that I enjoy to an extent. But when it comes to the vehicles, I'm not really happy about it. I feel they're missing that authentic feel of, like, hopping into TIE Fighter and X-Wing and, like, taking off with it. That's one thing I feel they're missing. That really kind of bothers me a little bit. And I don't know if that's going to be the final aspect of the game or this is just the beta and just the game mode itself, but that's what I'm getting from it, and I'm really not too happy about it. So what you do need to keep in mind is this is beta, right? This is not the final product. This is close to the final product. So shit's either going to change or it's going to be new. So only two game modes were actually thrown out at us. And that was the Walker Assault, which I play a lot of, and that's a lot of the gameplay I'm providing today. And there was Drop Zone, which I recorded one match. So I'll be throwing some gameplay into that a little bit later. So with the Drop Zone, it was purely infantry, so there was no vehicle combat. That's just kind of how the way it went. And with the Walker Assault, they had all the vehicle combat, right? The AT-ATs, the AT-STs, you had your snowspeeders, your TIE bombers, your TIE fighters, your Y-wings, your A-wings, your snowspeeders, and so on, right? They had like a large variety of vehicles to kind of test out. And this is where we're moving into the pros, by the way. So with that said, I hate the power-up, but I love the vehicle play. The vehicle play is really nice. It's not complicated. You basically hop in. Now, as I said, I'm playing it with on PC. So WASD keys, so you move forward, you know, your whatever, and your turning is purely your mouse. Wherever the fuck your mouse points is where your thing's gonna go. It's not gonna fuck off all over you, and you know, there's no pitch or yaw or any crap like that, right? It's just strictly use your mouse, use your cursor. I'm not sure what it's like on consoles. I imagine it's similar. Which I found was really nice. It was a very easy way to just hop in a vehicle and go and have a little bit of fun with it. The F1 to F4 keys, I believe, were your maneuvers. And I never really quite got down there. There's a little bar on the bottom, and I think it's between like your speed and what you're shooting and your different maneuvers and how you can use them. Because I remember back in the old Battlefronts, you could maneuver all the fucking time if you wanted to get away from people. In this one, it's different. It's you've got like, I would press a maneuver and do a backflip, get in behind somebody, shoot them down, and then I'd be getting shot at, try to do it again, and nothing would happen, right? So I'm not sure if they kind of balanced that out or what. But anyway, so that's kind of how that felt, and I really enjoyed that. I thought that was a really easy pick up and go. I'm not sure if that's going to change or if that's going to stay, and I really do hope it stays, because it's very easy for someone who has no idea what the fuck Battlefront is, or Battlefield for that instance, hop into this game and just be able to enjoy it and play. The guy wouldn't even have to know like a Star Wars, and it would be absolutely amazing for somebody to just pick up and play. It's a very fun game, very easy to get into, very pretty. You know, very intense at times battle to continue on with. So it's very interesting. I enjoyed it. So we're going to get into some of the other different things that they've added in, which I find really neat. The card system is something that is brand new and something that I feel is very first-person shooter-ish. So they've added in these cards that allow you to have grenades or sniper rifles or jetpacks or, you know, a personal shield or what's called an ion shot. And this is just what's been involved in the beta, and I imagine it's just going to be continuously more cards and more and more of just different cool things you can combine together. So your character has three different slots you can use. Now, each card needs to go in a different slot. So, for instance, the thermal detonator, which is a grenade, can go in either the first or third slot, whereas your sniper rifle, the cycler rifle, can go in the first or third slot. But when it comes to your ion shot, it has to go in the middle. Can't go anywhere else. Can't go to the left, can't go to the right, can't go in your first or third slot, it's got to go in your second. So you're not able to combine, say, thermal detonator, jetpack, and cycler rifle, because that's a pretty overpowered combination. You could jump, throw a grenade, pull out your sniper rifle, and snipe a fucker across the map all within a second. You know, it's something that I would feel would be a bit overpowered. But with that said, that's a very interesting way to balance out some gameplay. It's a very interesting way to do that. So with grenades, there's no more ammunition anymore. Not even with the blasters, which I find kind of interesting. It just overheats. Now, you can click it at a certain point and hit R, and it, or for me, the reload button, and it will actually, like, stop its cooldown process and just instantly cool, and you're good to go again. And it's very hard to hit. It's a little space, and if you fuck up, it's this huge deal, right? You're waiting longer for your weapon to cool down, which I thought was an interesting aspect to it. A lot of the time I just let it cool down because I'm not very good at hitting buttons at the right time. So that's just kind of how I roll. But anyway, so this card system they've laid out, it's very interesting. And the next one I'm going to bring up is the blasters, or the weapons that you get. So these are new, And they've only included 4 in the beta, and as I said, I imagine there's just going to be a fuck ton more that are going to be added later in the full game. But for now, this is just kind of a taste of how Battlefront is. So you've got your normal Rebel, your Rebel Blaster, your E-11 Imperial Blaster, and then there's a couple other ones. So there's one that looks like the MG-34, it's a machine gun blaster, and then one that's a pistol, like an automatic pistol. One, and I use the automatic pistol one in here a lot. This is, I just got it today. You actually use credits to unlock them. You have to be a certain rank, pay for it. Not actual real money, but you know, your credits in game. So your score adds up to credits in game. So how well you do in a match will determine how much money you get at the end of the game, or how many credits, I should say. And it will actually continue on to be able to buy different things. So new cards and new weapons and, you know, I'm assuming new skins and stuff, because there's a character customization that's not available in beta, but will be available in the full game, which I think is going to be really neat. So it's just going to be, you know, whatever the fuck you want it to be. You could make a, you know, a pretty badass stormtrooper or rebel soldier, whatever. You know, it really depends on who you're playing and what you're doing and everything else. So we'll see how that goes. As far as the gameplay is concerned, everything feels really well balanced. That's the one thing I found. Now there's a lot of people saying out there that the Empire is like extremely overpowered in this Walker Assault and everything else, and I don't feel it really is. I think it's meant to be hard for the rebel soldiers in this sense, because you're being attacked by gigantic armored camels basically that are marching towards you, that's trying to fuck up your base, and you've got like nothing, which is exactly what happened in the movies. So yeah, it's a bit of a challenge for the rebel, you know, people, right? And it'll automatically switch your sides if you lose or if you win as the rebels, right? You'll be switched to the Empire, so you get a chance to do reverse roles, which is really nice. So, with that said, I do still feel everything's really well balanced. Even the weapons itself, right? Some will do more damage close range or far range or whatever, but that's just the way it goes, right? Some of them are harder to control, some of them are easier to control. But when it comes down to it, it's not like it was in Battlefield 4, for instance, where it was the first person to shoot and hit was the person that got the kill. It is now down to who has the best aim. And I think that's a key aspect to a first-person shooter, because it makes it either more difficult or easier for people. And it will eventually, you know, develop your skills to become a better gamer when it comes to the FPS world. When you're relying on aim alone, other than you hit first. There's been times where I've been sitting here, the guy's at 2 health, I've been shooting and shooting and shooting, and the guy turns around and ends up killing me, and I've been at full health the entire time, right? That's something that I enjoy. That's a really fun, it's a frustrating aspect, but it's fun, because it's like, okay, well, yeah, good for you, man, good for you. When it comes down to the core gameplay, so actually playing, being surrounded by Imperial troops or Rebel troops, going towards an objective and trying to take it and everything, it feels really nice. It feels like real teamwork. It feels like a Battlefront game, and that's what I was really, really hoping when EA announced Battlefront. I thought, fuck, EA is taking it over. It's going to be another Battlefield 4. It's going to be another Battlefield Hardline. It's not going to be very good. And as I said, it may not own up to the old games, but it's going to be great for this next gen, you know, kind of era of consoles and graphics and just different things. You know, people's PCs are getting better and better every year. People's games are getting better and better every year. The consoles are needing to keep up. The PS4 and the Xbox One are the perfect examples for that, right? We're in the next gen phase. And, you know, it really doesn't seem all that long ago we were in the next gen phase with the 360 and the PS3, right? I'm still rocking the PS3, and I love it, but PC's where it's at for sure. Now when it boils all down to it and everything else, it's going to be Battlefront needs to stick to its roots. It really does. And one really cool aspect about sticking to its roots, it's got the first and third person views again in its settings menu. Unfortunately, I didn't show any gameplay from it, but I played both first and third person throughout a match just to kind of compare. And I remember in the old Battlefronts, the third person was the way to go. The first person just didn't work, almost. It was cool. It was neat to see your blaster in front of you or your rocket launcher, whatever it was, and how it was designed in the first person. But it was difficult to play as first person. Your field of view didn't feel all that right, and you just never had your aim properly. So third person was where it was at. In this,
both of them are, as I said, very well balanced. The both played similar. I prefer the first person because I enjoy the Star Wars universe. I enjoy the weapons. I enjoy the art style of how they've made their weapons and the amount of time and energy they put into it. And that was something that I really liked. So that's exactly what I was rocking, was the first person, because I enjoy first person shooters and for the reason I just gave. I'm really not sure kind of what else to get into. The battles itself just feel extremely intense. They're massive and they're really fun, and it's really interesting that way. And I imagine PC is going to be a bit better because it'll be bigger games, right? More people are able to be handled on a server than say a PS4 and Xbox One. But I believe Xbox One and PS4 for Battlefield 4 ended up making it so it was 64 player servers, which it normally would be on a PC. So that means that they can handle up to that much their servers, which is nice. The bigger, for Battlefront anyway, the better, because it's just intense battles and there's just so much going on and so much destruction and chaos. And I love it. I really do. I'm extremely excited for the final version. I'm extremely excited to what they're going to be throwing out next. It's something brand new and exciting for Star Wars fans alike, who are gamers. And I'm just really excited for it. Another thing I'm going to throw out there, as far as power-ups are concerned, heroes are back. And they gave two of us, they gave two of them to us in this Battlefront beta, which was Darth Vader and Luke Skywalker, of course. I accidentally picked up a hero, like power up, pick up, or whatever. And I was Luke Skywalker, and holy fuck. Once again, it's very balanced gameplay. Yes, you're a bit overpowered, but you can still die, and that's the one thing that I found. I stuck to the trenches in Hoth, as you'll see, there's many of them around, and got a few kills racked up before an AT-AT ended up taking me out, along with like six other soldiers and an AT-ST, right? Everybody gangs up on you. And you only have so much health, so they'll knock it down until you're done. But you've got different things. So you've got, for Luke, there was like the jump hit and the force push, which is basically using your force to push somebody. And one was like a heart attack or whatever. And for Vader, there is the force choke, which happened to me and I thought was quite amusing. I was actually more excited about dying than I was playing. He's got his throw lightsaber and his just normal attack. And I'm not sure there's going to be a third. I think there's a third special in there as well. I'm just not sure what it is. But anyway, I thought it was absolutely amazing. I was like, oh my god, this is such a cool way to bring in the heroes. It's such a cool way to balance the gameplay as far as I was concerned. Because when it came to Battlefront 2, it was basically like, you got a hero card and that was that. You know, you were winning the fucking game. I don't think it was a card. Like, you finally got the hero and that was that. You could just fuck everybody up and have a great day. With this, it's, you have a chance. You know, and I watched Frankie on PC in 1080p's video on Battlefront a couple of days ago, and he was just saying that, you know, if you're shooting at them, you're blocking their shots and they're going back to them, and it's a panicking range. And I totally feel what he's saying, because it's true. When you've got one of these people coming at you and you're like, oh fuck, oh fuck, oh fuck, it's all you're doing is shooting, but really you're killing yourself because you're shooting the fucking blasters and it's, you know, it's hitting back at you, which I found was amusing. So it made me giggle a few times, because that's exactly what I did. I panic, shoot Darth Vader or Luke Skywalker, and ended up having these shots back at me and kill myself. So that was pretty amusing, and it's funny seeing other people do it too, because it's everybody's reaction, just sheer panic and firing and hoping that it's going to do something. So yeah, all levels of gameplay feel extremely balanced. All the weapons are extremely balanced for what they're used for. And that's something I really enjoy about this game, is something that's new and exciting that needs to happen more often in video games, especially with EA. I think they're going to hit the nail on the head with this one. I really do. There's one more thing that I found, and I think it's in one of these gameplays, and I'll show you. It's not snowing outside and off. It's bright, you know, blue sky and fucking, you know, there's obviously snow, but I mean, there's nothing there. And when you're inside a building to look outside, it's sheer white at the doorway until you step outside, and then everything comes to. And I'm like, that doesn't seem right. It's not like it's snowing or there's like a crap ton of anything in the way. It's just, that's what you're providing us, is this sheer white thing. So people can see into the base perfectly fine from the outside, but outside shooting, you know, inside shooting out, it's a complete different mess. So I think I'll throw it in here at some point in time. This is nice. I'm actually recording this before I'm editing, so I apologize if, you know, what I'm talking about doesn't necessarily sync up with the video. I'm just going to be throwing gameplay in there just to kind of show you guys what it's about. Yeah, so if you missed out on the Battlefront beta, that's unfortunate, but check out some gameplay footage and kind of get a feel for it and what it's going to be. I definitely recommend this to buy full on, just if not for the gameplay, if not to enjoy it, just for the Battlefront, you know, series itself, because it brings back a lot of old memories from a long time ago. And, you know, I love it. I do. I really love it. I think they really did it this time. Just fucking phenomenal. Good on you, EA. You know, I'm pretty sure they have their sun glare shit in here again as well, which is a trademark, but, you know, that's a little bit frustrating, but I mean, I can get over it. This is a new experience, honestly. It's a new feel of a game, which is really great. I think EA's finally fucking done it. They've done a good job. And DICE as well has been working on it. So, you know, it's got to have some half-assed decent gameplay. And, I mean, the character customization is going to be nuts. And just the way everything looks is great. And sorry that I'm going to be adding in a couple more points here. Like, just pay attention to the gameplay and blaster hits that are hitting off stuff. It's, like, sparking like it would be in the movies. Like, they've done such a good job at just the small little attentions to detail. And, like, their explosions look realistic. And even when, you know, like an AT-AT, when a fucking shell hits or one of their laser blasters hits, it creates a massive fucking puff of snow and dirt and shit. It's awesome because you're like, oh my god, I feel like I'm there. That's great. That's the experience I want. That's what I fucking want in a Star Wars Battlefront game, is that experience of being in that battlefield. That's exactly what you want, right? Or as close to Star Wars as possible. And that's something I think they've done quite well. And another thing is that I found was really cool is being in an Imperial, even fucking Rebel, and just standing underneath an AT-AT. Once it fires, if you're looking through a scope or something, you're shaky and you feel it, you know. Like, I'm playing on PC and there's absolutely no rumble packs in anything or whatever, but I mean, like, you feel it, you know what I mean? So that was something I found that was really cool. I don't know. It made it feel like a kind of a realistic Star Wars game, if that's something to say. And yeah, I think it's gonna be really fun. I really hope they don't rape us with fucking DLCs, because I'm really sick of that. I really think there should be a lot more. And there is a single player mode, judging by the menu options. I'm not sure if it's gonna be like it was in the original Battlefront. I hope it is, because that was fun. And there's times where I'm not going to have internet connection, depending on where I am. So that would be really fun to play just by yourself, you know, just the classic Battlefront. But anyway, I think that's really all I've got to say. Yeah, that's really it. So, yeah, if you guys haven't checked it out, that's unfortunate. Definitely get it when it comes out. I believe its date for release is November 17th of this year, which should be absolutely wonderful. So less than a month away, or just a little over a month away, sorry. And yeah, it's going to be great. I can't wait to pick it up. So yeah, keep tuning in, I guess, around November 17th for some more gameplay, because I'm definitely going to be picking this title up. And, but maybe not, because if I believe November 11th is when Fallout 4 drops, so I'm going to be picking that up. And that'll be my main game for playing. So I am going to be getting a PS4 in the next month. So Fallout 4 gameplay is going to be recorded on the PS4, because it really sucks lugging this computer around to work. I work all over the place. I'm constantly on the road. So trucking this with me in a suitcase is kind of hard sometimes. You know, tower, monitor, keyboard, mouse. Just a lot to truck around. It's fairly heavy. But anyway... yeah, so I will see you guys in the next video. This has been Ninja Wire and Battlefront. So, yeah, take it easy, guys.